this afternoon that we would split, as Mayor Keanu suggested, to give a little bit more, give you all a little bit more time to share your thoughts and inputs on things. And we thought that, as we're not a large group, I think we can basically split into two groups. So we'll discuss that in a minute. And I think seeing as such a big theme from this morning was this issue about, you know, the centrality of locality, if I can put it that way, right? That there's a strong appeal for us to think more about local circumstances and really factor those into the discussion of what these local partnerships for poverty eradication might look like. And I think Ben's point this morning about HEIs having more autonomy. So we wanted to kind of take you to a world, for you to help us imagine a world where HEIs do have that greater autonomy. And with that autonomy, how then do we maximize the opportunity for strengthening partnerships at the local level for poverty reduction? The other thing that came out, I think, strongly from this morning was that with that focus on local circumstances, that we move away from sectoral groupings and sectoral perspectives. Not that they're unimportant, but they're not a sufficient lens for us to think about leaving no one behind. And, you know, for example, in a general way, we may say farmers and fishers are, you know, clearly a group that is being left behind, being disadvantaged. But the kinds of policies and interventions that may be relevant may well vary, are likely to vary, from locality to locality. So we need to move away from generalizations and really look at the local circumstances, so that the challenges that face farmers in Arm may be rather different from the challenges that farmers in Region 8 may face, for example. So to try to get beyond sectoral perspective. And we also heard a lot this morning about data and data needs. And the question is, what kind of data do we need at the local level to inform, to have a more informed discussion? And that may vary from the data collection efforts of national government agencies, for example. So kinds of data that need to be collected using CDMS, using administrative data, using other sources of data, and how that is brought into the discussion. And also we talked about capacities and roles for HEIs. And so I think these are all issues for you to kind of think about as we break you into two groups. These are the questions that we'd like to pose for you to reflect on this afternoon. It is a focus on partnerships, and that's picking up from Noel's point this morning about, you know, the value of having stronger partnerships between HEIs, private sector, NGOs, national government, local government, and that response to scaling up or scaling down, replicating horizontally and vertically. So thinking about those partnerships. And we'd invite you to do that from the perspective of who you are, both as an individual and in terms of the organization and agency that you may be representing here today. So what are those kinds of opportunities? What are the constraints? We've talked about some of them this morning, but I'm sure there will be others that come up during that discussion. And if we're beginning to look towards a little bit of a forward-looking agenda, what kind of solutions are needed then to respond to those constraints and realize the opportunity? So those are the three questions that we'd invite you to reflect on. In terms of splitting you into the two groups, those of you from HEIs, could you just put your hands in the air for me at the moment? So one, two. Brother Arnin's hand is, you know, would be in the air. Or I guess you could play it, but either way, right? Okay. Okay. You've got a rip. Okay. Perfect. Sorry. So one more time for my benefit. Excuse me. One, two, three, four. Right. Obviously, haven't had my post-lunch coffee yet. So if you can just divide three and three and three between you, that's fine. We're not going to kind of overly manage this. And then the others, the non-HEIs, and also for the time being, my colleagues from UNDP and PIDS, not including you. So the other non-HEIs, could you put your hands in the air for me? Could you also split down the middle so that we have a roughly equal number one, two, three, four, five? So, okay, it looks about the same kind of thing. So we've got two groups of six, about, sounds about right. And then other colleagues will join you after the discussion has got going, but we don't want to bias your, we're mostly interested in hearing from you rather than hearing from ourselves, which we hear too much of anyway. So please do that. I think the room is large enough for you to have those discussions without too much interference from each other. And we're at 1:30 now, so we can come back at 2:30 at the latest. If you finish earlier, we can also come. Is that fairly clear? Any questions? Good. Okay, so ping, I shall, you know, bang the gong. Group two, there, and one.
This is nice place.
Okay, there. That's leadership. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. simply it's a great opportunity because if you've got much of it, here's a different approach which if telco infrastructure is in place, it's beneficial. You're telling me that it's impossible to find
I'm not saying it's impossible. I'm just saying because for RCTs, right, at the end of it, you need to be able to attribute the change to your intervention.
So